Hello, Resurrection friends, and welcome to our December class at Resurrection Family Religious Ed and our class All About Mary. I'm Mrs. Smith, and I've met you before, many of you, last year or through the years. And I'm really happy Miss Savannah asked me if I could come today because I love Mary. She's one of my favorite people. And I hope that after we talk about a few things and you do some activities, you're going to find a special place in your heart for Mary too. So Mary was chosen by God to be the mother of his son, Jesus. And Mary said yes. Mary was just a humble girl, not a princess, not from royalty, and she had no idea that she was so special. So the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and said God wanted her to be the mother of his son. Mary was a little afraid, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid. The Holy Spirit will give you grace, a special gift inside you to be the perfect mother for Jesus." So Mary said to the angel, "I am not afraid. Nothing will be impossible for God. Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." So, I am in a special place right now. This is a Mary garden. I'm at Ava and Sage's house, my granddaughters, and we have made a Mary garden. And I want to show you how simple it is so you could do one at your house too. We just found a place on the side of the house, and we found a Mary statue at home, and I spray painted her, and here she is. And we put some bulbs in, daffodils come up, and we have, the girls have rabbits and birds and little things around. You could just take a stone, a rock, and we put pray for us and put that in your garden. And you could put any special flower you want. And anytime someone comes by, they see Mary, they can say, "Mary, pray for us." They can say the Hail Mary, or you can just bless yourself. And it's just so easy. You just find a little place in your garden, anywhere, and have a Mary garden. And we're gonna show you some ideas later. So I'm gonna head back to my house now, and we're gonna talk about some more things that we learned from Mary. Hello again, and here we are back at my house. And I wanted to share with you a little prayer table that I have set up in the kitchen, just a really simple little snack tray. And I have a purple tablecloth on it because that is the liturgical color for Advent. And I have a really nice little Advent wreath, two candles lit for the second week of Advent, two purple candles. And of course, here's Mary featured on the table and her rosary and crucifix, a little prayer stone. And the Bible is open to the verse from Luke where Mary says, "I'm a handmaid of the Lord." So I thought it would be nice for us to do a meditation today with each other. And we begin by quieting our body, our mind, and our heart. And breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Breathe in the Holy Spirit. And breathe out your cares of the day. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Jesus, today we're talking about your beloved mother, Mary. Mary was just a simple girl, a humble girl, and she was really your first disciple. She knew you were special, and she wanted to help you and honor you in any way she could. Today, we want Mary to be for us, so we know how to say yes to you also, how to share, to listen to mom and dad, to care about creation and other people, we treasure, and it's really a nice way to honor Mary every day. So take a few moments right now, and in your own mind and heart, say something special to Mary that you would like to tell her. Ask her to pray for you, your family, your mom, your grandma, anyone, the world, and ask her to have Jesus keep you in his hand every day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, I hope this week you take a look at some of the activities, many of the activities, that are in the links for today's class about Mary, and enjoy some of them with your family at home. There's some really nice ones. You can even make a statue of Mary out of paper if you don't have one. And there's a really nice short video with three girls signing, doing sign language to the Hail Mary with music. So I really enjoyed that, and I think you'll like it too. There's also a link to how to make a Mary terrarium, so you can do it in the winter if you're inside your house. So I just took a plant I had and I put Mary inside it with some berries for Christmas and a little prayer stone. And I thought that way you could have your own little garden. I could have my own little garden. You could do something little. I just have a little plastic statue in there, and you can have her with you all season. And this is my very special statue of Mary, which I've had for probably 40 years, and I love her. And I still have Mary on my dresser every day so I can say a special prayer to her. So I hope for the rest of Advent you find a way to keep Mary in your heart. And she has a special feast day coming up this week, the Immaculate Conception on December 8th. Mary was the only person conceived and born without original sin other than Jesus. So she has many special names. She's loved the whole world over. She's Our Lady of Grace, Our Lady of Lourdes, Our Lady of the Rosary. So Mary is just someone who is beloved in every country. There's also a little short slideshow in your links that shows Mary painted by different artists and different cultures of the world. So I hope you have something now to help you keep Mary and Christ in Christmas. And I thought maybe we could end our session today with Mary's very own prayer, the Hail Mary. So hands together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And I wanted to say that I wore blue today because blue is traditionally the color of Mary, so I thought that would be something nice to share today. So it was a great experience being here with you. I wish you a very happy and holy Advent and Christmas, and I hope to see you soon. Bye now.